anybody to the roar. Anybody that's ever told you you can't do something. Let's draw a line in the sand and say, you know what? Today, I'm running right back towards that. I am not afraid. Will you play afraid today?
No, sir.
Are you going to play afraid today?
No, sir.
Will you, Eli?
No, coach.
Well, then every rep, every special teams play, I want to see guys flying down the field and putting your face on somebody's face. We got it?
Yes, sir.
Put your face on somebody. Hey, dog, it's going to be a long day. It's going to be a long day.
Howard University has excelled at all levels of academia, but has failed to do so on the gridiron. Until Mike London, ACC Coach of the Year. He comes to Howard highly coveted from the University of Maryland. After coming off a 2-9 season last year at a school such as Howard, a.k.a. the Mecca, the expectations are high, and Mike London plans to meet those expectations. As he mentors his young men, Coach Mike London understands that he is in a rebuilding process, but he and his coaching staff are up for the challenge.
I'm the son of a retired military non-commissioned officer that has two brothers and a sister that has lived in Libya, Africa, Wiesbaden, Germany, California, Hawaii. You know, the military life takes you all over. And I've adopted the philosophy that, you know, wherever you go to be significant and make an impact where you are. So I'm also a guy that's been a police officer, you know, in my early development, professional development. Worked at the Boys and Girls Club of Richmond, Virginia. I'm a big community person, an advocate of bone marrow drives, as I was a bone marrow donor 14 years ago and actually saved my daughter's life by a bone marrow transplant at Johns Hopkins Hospital in Maryland. And so I'm a lot of different things. All of us are kind of parts of the experiences we've had, you know, growing up and going from young adulthood to adulthood. I'm a father of seven. So I was a Dallas Cowboy free agent. I don't know if I can say that. Dallas Cowboys and around Redskin territory. But it's an experience, you know, that you have that you cherish. And I've been coaching now for 20 plus years. And so I'm a sum total of a lot of things that through life experiences have made me grateful and very humble.
Through all this heartbreak and this pain, I can't change. Through the betrayal and the rain, I stay the same. I promise you that I'ma leave how I came. Gotta stop playing, now it's time to be a man. It ain't a thing I can't handle, I'm a champion. It ain't a thing I can't handle, I'm the chosen one.
As the 2-2 Bison Soldiers take the field to face off against 3-1 North Carolina Central, a game that many believe if the Bison win will solidify their presence within the MEAC as a top contender. After a hard-fought loss to Central, Howard will go on to play Delaware State and defeat them soundly. Currently, Howard is preparing for their homecoming game against the Morgan State Bears.
This is the closest I've ever seen this team become close. Like the closest. I feel like I have a bond with the coaches. Coaches have a bond with me. Then I also have a bond with a closer bond with my teammates, which I haven't had over the course of my time at Howard University. So you know what he's brought here is amazing. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing what else he brings to the table as Howard football continues to progress over the course of the years as he's the head coach.
Our mindset is that you know, we believe that we can win. We practice like we, you know, that we can win. Our mindset is that we believe in the schemes and the systems that, you know, that that we utilize. So it's a matter of just, you know, our physical makeup, our mental makeup, you know, all those things that have to come into play when you're playing a really good team like Central.
In the last four games, you've rushed for 428 yards, averaging 6 yards per carry. That's pretty impressive for it to be so early in the season. So it's a testament to who you are, but we want to know, who is Caleb Newton?
Well, I'm a team player first, a man of God, and just doing it, whatever it takes to win, you know, for my teammates. If it's run, throw, sacrifice my body, it really doesn't matter. The team's first.
And would you consider Howard to be a part of who you're becoming?
Most definitely. I mean, it's the best decision I probably ever made in my life.
And I ask because recently I read an article, the Washington Post, where you said Howard is your...
Auburn in Alabama.
And can you elaborate on what you meant by that?
Well, I feel like most athletes think that they have to go big to make it or have to go big to be happy or successful. But Howard is perfect for me, you know. It gives me every opportunity to succeed academically and athletically.
People are moved by the way you make them feel. And some of the things, you know, the three tenets of the program are go to class, show class, treat people with dignity and respect. Those are ongoing, everyday, re-emphasizing things that need to be modeled and talked about. It was difficult at first. There were some that didn't want to adopt those standards, and so they're no longer with the program. There are some that are still here that we are continuing to make sure that we that the best thing for them to do is to do, you know, some of the things that we've asked. And I think that these guys have to understand that they'll be husbands, fathers, employees, employers. They'll own companies. They'll be hiring, firing. There'll be so many things that they'll be doing. And I believe that those tenets we just talked about are things that can help them achieve that after having the life experiences once again, you know, being a police officer, the term treat people with dignity and respect. That's why I learned that, that literally what comes out of your mouth is the power of life and death. And what you say, you can escalate or de-escalate situations. So you kind of take that and you put it all into your, if you're going to run a program, how you'd run it. And you take your life experiences, you bring in great coaches like I have on the staff here. You're in a situation where there's support, you know, from the president to the AD on down to students that work with the program, then it's a why not, you know, opportunity. And that's why the whole Mission Possible thing is all kind of crafted up into the whole message. And is the culture changing? I would hope so. I'm on the inside, not on the outside looking in. Other people can talk about that, but we sure do hope that it is for the benefit of the student athletes that we're responsible for.
Since he's been here, I definitely feel that the culture has changed. He's bringing in that winning attitude that he's carried with him for the years that he's coached, and just bringing that to Howard and helping us change the culture here, turn us into a winning program.
We wanted to raise our football IQ about how you do things, how you play the game, the strategies of it, the techniques employed. And so as the season has gone on, we've really done a great job of winning close games. We've won blowout games. We've won games that people never thought we could. And so it's been really, it's been a joy watching the maturation process of not only a student athlete, but guys that become better teammates. You know, they've increased their GPAs in the classroom. They've increased their personal brand in the community. So I think all those things are components of a development from A to Z. I would say going into the latter part of the season now at 7-3, we've done a great job with our conference record. We've only had one loss right now in our conference, and we have a chance for postseason play opportunities. So it's been really humbling, kind of a worst to first scenario. But we believe in the process, and as we stated at the very beginning, that mission is possible. And thus far, to this point in the season, very pleased, very happy to say our guys have done a great job. Our coaching staff has done a great job as well.
That's the ultimate success of a team, is the direct effect of individual efforts. Today, individual efforts will lead to the ultimate success of the team.